Divine Twins. This is Debs, and this is your Twin Flame journey for the month of April 2024. Thank you, Divine Twins, for being here. Let's find out what may be happening between the masculine and the feminine for this coming month of April. The deck that I'm using is The Signs of Sun by Solid Universe. Let's move into this and have a look at the energies. Let's see what's going on. Calling on the divine, the higher angels and ascended masters from the pure white light, please guide me in this twin flame reading for the collective. What's going on pertaining to the masculine and the feminine? Thank you, Archangel Michael. Thank you. Don't know why I'm hearing the word parched. It may be that someone here feels devoid of love. Maybe somebody here is missing their twin's energy. I'm hearing the word empty. Someone feels empty about the other person. Empty. Okay. Ooh, twins, heavy energy. All right. As you know, Archangel Michael does not permit me to cut the deck for twin flame readings. So let's see what's going on. Cards are going on the table. As always, the top line of cards represent the masculine's energy, the feminine below. Okay, twins. Six cards for the masculine, six for the feminine. As you guys know, energies can switch. You could be a feminine coming through as the masculine and vice versa. Are we going to fit all the cards on the table? Just about. Just about, twins. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Final card for the masculine. Final card for the feminine. All right, that's pretty good. Now, the card in the center will show me the energy between the two of you, irrespective of whether or not there's any communication. It's just the energy both of you carry for the journey. All right. Underneath the deck, we have the Hanged Man, Pisces energy. Someone here may be realizing they have been self-sacrificing. Wow. And underneath that, we have the High Priestess. Very strong Pisces coming through. Okay. Someone here could be incredibly intuitive. We may have a divine feminine here or a masculine who is a light worker. So divine twins, let's move into this and see what comes through. As always, of course, we're going to be looking at the energy of the divine masculine. Let's have a look and see what energy he's sitting in at this current point of time. The Empress. So the divine masculine may be coming through carrying the energy of the Empress, or the divine masculine is simply realizing he is ready for reunion with his divine feminine, who is normally coming through with the energy of the Empress. Now, contrary to that, the Empress can potentially pertain to wife and mother. So the masculine may be trying to decide to detach from a wife or mother of his children to be with his true divine feminine. Interesting energy. He could be dealing with a Taurus or a Libra significantly. So divine twins, we move to the first card for the feminine. Let's have a look and see what's on the feminine's mind and how she is feeling. The Nine of Pentacles. So the divine feminine is sat in pre-Empress energy. She's strong, she's wise, she's grounded, she's independent. This is a feminine who's worked very hard on her stability. She is ready for union. So twins, let's have a look at the second card for the masculine. This is going to show us how he sees his true divine feminine, what he believes is on her mind, how he believes she's feeling. So this is his point of view. The Eight of Coins. So the way he sees the divine feminine feeling is that she has to work on her own stability. She has to keep herself strong and think clearly, keep her feet on the ground, concentrate on her own foundation, because she may be losing faith that the masculine will ever move towards her to reunite. It may well be that the masculine feels in the 5D, the feminine is wanting to work on reunion with him. So that is how he sees his true divine feminine. So we move now to the second card for the feminine. And of course, this is going to show how she sees her true divine masculine, what she believes is on his mind, how she believes he's feeling. This is her perspective. The Lovers. The way she sees her true divine masculine is that he may be involved in a long-term situation with someone else. These two could have been lovers at some point of time. She may simply see her masculine needing to make a choice between her and a wife or mother of his children. She may simply feel that her true divine masculine is a Gemini. Okay, twins. We now move to the third card for the masculine. This, of course, is going to show us how he sees the actual relationship, the connection with his true divine feminine. This may also give us an indication of what he's hoping for with the divine feminine pertaining to their connection. The Moon. Cancerian energy. The Moon pertains to deep feelings. The Moon also pertains to secrets. The divine masculine may have been trying to keep a secret that he is involved in a long-term situation. He may have been trying to keep this from his true divine feminine, but I believe she already knows that he is not single. He's very afraid of the connection. He may feel very intensely for the divine feminine. He's trying to make a decision that I'm hearing is fair and balanced for everyone involved. He knows that she is his true divine feminine, but I believe he's in a long-term relationship with someone else, and he would need to make a decision to detach from that woman in order to make it work with his feminine. He's still sitting on the fence. He's obviously kept this connection with the divine feminine secret from potentially his wife or mother of his children. She does not know that this divine feminine exists. Let's have a look at the third card for the feminine. This is going to show us how she sees the connection, the relationship moving forward with her true divine masculine. The Page of Cups. The feminine feels that before any further conversation takes place, the masculine should apologize to her. It could be apologizing for keeping a secret that he's involved in a long-term relationship with another woman. She may feel as if he was deceptive in some way in hiding that from her. The Page of Cups can also pertain to an expression of love. So the feminine would want the masculine to move towards her to admit that there is love between the two of them, because this may have started as simply a physical connection. She wants to know, does the masculine truly love her? So, divine twins, we come to the fourth cards, and these are going to portray the messages that each twin wants to relay to the other twin. Messages, of course, as always, of love and support for the journey itself. These could be questions and also pieces of information sent between the souls in dream state during astral travel. Let's have a look at what the masculine wants to relate to the feminine for the month of April. The Three of Cups. If the masculine has not already come clean to his true divine feminine to admit this started as a third party situation, he is wanting to express that and to apologize. I am so sorry, but I hid from you that I was in a relationship with someone else. Now, the Three of Cups can also relate to reunion and celebration. So the masculine may be wanting the feminine to know that he's very close to making a decision to leave a karmic partner to be with her. The Three of Cups is what the masculine is wanting to relay to his true divine feminine. So twins, let's now have a look at what the feminine would want to relay to her true divine masculine. And this could be in response to what he is relaying to her. Let's see. The Four of Cups. What I'm hearing is, if you decide to move towards me without detaching from a long-term situation, I will simply turn you away. I'm not interested in simply an offer of love. I know my worth, I know what I deserve, and I'm standing strong in that truth. She is not interested in any type of third-party situation because this is a divine feminine who has awoken. Now, twins, we move to the fifth cards. And of course, this is going to portray the challenges that each twin faces that they need to overcome in order to move into union in the 3D in this lifetime. So let's have a look at the challenges the divine masculine faces, challenges he needs to overcome in order to come into union with his true divine feminine. Let's see. Yes, the Page of Swords. His main challenge is that he would need to be open and honest with everyone involved. This may pertain to him needing to have a serious, straightforward conversation with his wife or mother of his child or children. I'm so sorry, but I feel I need to tell you the truth that I've met my true divine feminine. He knows also that his challenge is to be open and honest with his true divine feminine about his real status, if he wasn't honest before, even though she may already have intuited with the High Priestess energy we saw under the deck that he is involved in a long-term connection with another woman. His challenge from the divine is to be open and honest and speak his truth. Divine twins, we move now to the fifth card for the divine feminine. And of course, this is going to show the challenges she faces, the blocks that she needs to remove from the twin flame path in order to come together with her true divine masculine. Let's have a look. The Ten of Swords. The challenge for the divine feminine is that she feels betrayed by the masculine. It could be the trust is gone. Even though the masculine may be preparing to move towards her to come into union, she doesn't know if she can trust him in the future. Would he lie to her in the future? Would he deceive her again? She doesn't know if she's really ready to welcome him into her life. She needs to ensure that he's fully ascended in order to consider opening the door. So this started as a third-party situation for many of you. So twins, we come to the penultimate two cards. These, as always, are going to portray what each twin is hoping for, pertaining to the connection with the other twin by the end of April 2024. Let's have a look at the Divine Masculine's energies to see what he's hoping for pertaining to the feminine by that time. The Nine of Swords. I feel the Divine Masculine will be in a state of stress. Stress because he realizes who his true divine feminine is. Stress because he's realizing that she is not going to accept an ongoing third party situation. He will have to make a decision, and that decision is to do the right thing. With the Nine of Swords, he may be receiving downloads from the divine. I don't know why, but I'm seeing a pyramid here with a cat. It may well be that these two met initially in Egypt, a very deep past life connection. They've met again in this lifetime to come into union, and he may suddenly be realizing the significance of this connection. Now, this may pertain to the fact that even though he is considering moving into union with a feminine, considering ending a karmic relationship, he may not be ready to do that in the month of April. And it might pertain to the fact that he's not sure if his feminine is ready to accept him back. Even if I leave a karmic partner, I don't know if my true divine feminine would open the door again. She knows I've deceived her. I know that she's been hurt. Is this truly done? Have I destroyed our chance of union in the 3D simply because I wasn't honest? It may be a challenge for the masculine. So, Divine Twins, we come to the final card for the feminine. And of course, this is going to show us what she's hoping for pertaining to her divine masculine. And remember, this could be a subconscious wish. The Eight of Swords. So the divine feminine will be stuck in her head because the divine masculine is not moving. She may feel that he is trying to make a decision, but he can't make that decision. She, in turn, is also unsure as to whether or not she would open the door to him and come into union with him, even if he did decide to end a long-term relationship. So with a hangman energy, it may be that both twins feel that they've met their true divine partners, but they are both unsure as to whether or not they want to consider reunion in the 3D. So this is challenging for both twins. We come to the final card, and as you guys will know, this will show us the energy between these two souls by the end of April 2024. Let's have a look. The Six of Cups, yes. Both twins are sat in the past. Both twins are sat in nostalgia, thinking about memories when they first met, wondering if the other would reach out. I don't think these two are in communication, but they're both heavily thinking about each other at this point of time. So, Divine Twins, are you ready for messages? Let's have a look and see what the masculine would want to say to the feminine and vice versa. Archangel Michael, may we first of all have messages from the divine feminine to the divine masculine. From the divine feminine to the masculine. Thank you, Michael. Thank you. The divine feminine is saying to the masculine, I can't offer you anything more right now. She's pulled her energy right back. She's not willing to consider a third party situation or to get involved with him again if he is still sat with a karmic partner. She's making that very clear. Second message from the feminine to the masculine. I recognized you the moment our eyes met. So the feminine knows, or she did know, instantly that she'd met her true divine masculine. It may have taken the masculine longer to recognize her as his true divine feminine. Instant soul recognition. Archangel Michael, may we have a final message from the divine feminine to the masculine? Thank you. I'm afraid to open my heart. The feminine is sat in a lot of fear of being hurt and deceived again. May we now have messages from the divine masculine to the divine feminine? Thank you. The divine masculine says to the feminine, I'm worried about you moving on. He is realizing that if he does not take action in the next few weeks or few months, he will lose the opportunity of being with the feminine, maybe forever. Second message, please, Archangel Michael, from the masculine to the feminine. I'm not ignoring you. I'm thinking about our connection. So yes, these two are not in communication in the 3D, but I feel there's a lot that's going on energetically in the fifth dimension. The masculine is heavily thinking about this connection, understanding he's met his true divine twin. He is nervous, though, that even if he does end the connection with his karmic, he's nervous that the feminine would still decide to turn him away because I feel she was hurt in the past. What is the divine masculine saying to the feminine? Final card, please, Michael. Yeah. The divine masculine says to the feminine, I can hear you even in the silence. He may be finally recognizing who she is to him. But it remains to be seen as to whether or not he has the courage to reach out to the feminine, let alone take charge of his connection with his long-term partner. So, Divine Twins, a little bit of a challenging reading, but I hope you've enjoyed it. If you'd like your own twin flame reading, you can reach me. My website is in the description box below. Take care of you, sending love and light your way, and many blessings. Bye now.